Good. You've returned. You seem to be in one piece. Tell me, how do you like your new blade?
I hope it's thirsty. I plan on drowning it.
What are you doing, Father? I only just got my Warblade and I've been here 6 months.
I have my reasons, Escala. And you will not breathe a word of this to anyone. Do you hear?
Yes. Yes, Father.
Acolyte, this is Escala, my daughter. She's one of the advanced students here. On her way to becoming Sith. If she minds herself.
I'll keep quiet about your new charge, Father. But I won't be there if whatever you're planning blows up in your face.
Don't mind her. She's just sore that I'm keeping secrets. She growls, but she's loyal. Now, I thought I heard Venrin's voice in the adjacent chamber before you arrived. Did he make his move so soon?
Yeah, I hate him already. I look forward to ending his miserable existence.
If things go well, you will have that satisfaction someday. Still, I'd hoped we'd have more time. Venrin's not the type to sniff around for too long before trying to take a bite. In a drive for sheer numbers, the criteria for Academy admittance has been relaxed. Now anyone with Force sensitivity is allowed entrance. Venrin is mixed blood, the invisible rot eating at the foundation of the Empire. He must not be allowed to advance.
So, you're an elitist snob?
You say that like it's a bad thing. It's the Sith way. Only the best, only the most pure, should be good enough.
Unfortunately, Venrin's caught the eye of Darth Barriss, one of the most influential Sith lords. He's being groomed to be Barriss's new apprentice. As Darth Barriss's apprentice, the power at Venrin's fingertips will be considerable. He could change the Sith for the worse.
You must proceed to your next trial immediately. I want you to interrogate 3 prisoners in the Academy jails and decide their fates. Consider each criminal's story carefully. The decisions you make will be scrutinized, so let your passions guide your judgments.
I will handle it.
Go to the Academy prison. Speak to head jailer Nash and return to me after you've passed judgment on the prisoners.
One more chirp from you, little bird, and you'll regret it.
Chirp, chirp, chirp. Ow, jerk! If you don't like that, just say so. I can do other animals too. Dire cat, frog dog, quaking monkey lizard, you name it.
You, I'm Jailer Nash. I run these cells and slave pits. You're the acolyte Tremel sent for the test, right? He thinks highly of you.
Then I will repay his faith by sticking to my mission.
You should know this situation is highly unusual. Normally an acolyte goes off well for the interrogation. Overseer Tremel, at these 3 shipped in for you. He thinks you're the next coming of Exar Kun. But you ought to know, Tremel ain't the only one paying attention to you. Now, these 3 prisoners have been transferred here for your inspection. You gotta interrogate them as needed, and then decide their fate. The convicted are usually executed or given a trial by combat to see if they're worthy. Whatever you decide, You will be the one to carry out the sentence.
As it should be.
Ah, fine. Let's get started. This one on the left.
You freaks aren't getting anything new out of me! Just do whatever you're gonna do!
You can either talk to me or to the Inquisitors. And I promise, I have a much sunnier disposition.
Get lost! I've been through this routine. I already know all your Inquisitors by name.
Impudent to the last. As I was saying, she was sent to kill an Imperial spy in the Yavin system. Throughout her torture, she maintained that she was hired anonymously.
Get it through your damn head! I had no idea he was Imperial, and I don't know who hired me!
Regale me with the details of your operation. What was your chosen form of murder?
I didn't kill him. I was caught before I could pull it off.
The point is, she doesn't deny the charge. So now you must decide. Execution or trial by combat. Which do you choose?
Neither, actually. She could prove useful. Send her to Imperial Intelligence.
I won't work for free.
Huh. You spared her. Interesting.
Please. I am a fellow Sith. Judge me with an open mind and grant me trial by combat, I beg you.
Your name, now.
This part of Waste is Davotek. Once a valued Sith champion, until he botched an important mission and caused 1,000 Imperial deaths. Now look at him.
I served faithfully for 24 years. Then one mistake, and they threw me away. Now I have been left here to rot. Please, let me feel the weight of a weapon once more.
I will grant your wish. A warrior should die with his boots on.
My thanks, young warrior.
This should be entertaining. Well, he didn't put up much of a fight, did he?
He died.
Well, this last prisoner's a bit of a puzzle. He's called Breg, and he's a jittery little wretch, suspected of supplying forged documents to Republic agents. Strangely enough, he maintains his innocence, despite being severely tortured.
Nebaga imana, naki naya, bila magnam unya karnalebek.
Are you trying to tell me you've led a clean life?
Naki oya makmak. Nebaga imana, naki naya, bila magnam unya karnalebek.
He's never wavered from that line. And the evidence is circumstantial. I suppose it's actually possible he didn't do it. So, what do you decide?
I think in this case we should release him. Let him go.
Mamni lebek bak manuk. Meraka naja ki namapamyak.
Freedom, huh? That's a new one? Well, that's sad. You're an interesting one, kid. I can see why people are keeping tabs on you. Head back to Overseer Tremel. See what he thinks of your choices.
Sith blood's not everything. Lord Thrain dislikes my apprentice's privileged attitude.
Then he will never be Sith. A pity. He seemed strong.
Not strong enough for the tombs. I have seen to that.
Yes. Is this everything?
Everything Lord Renning was able to obtain, yes.
Then run back to your master in the beast pens before I cut you in half. Sorry to make you wait, Acolyte. These interruptions are incredibly annoying. On to the business at hand, your test in the jails. First, the assassin, Solence. She attempted to kill an Imperial spy, but was unaware of her client's affiliation. You assigned her to Imperial Intelligence. I commend you, that was excellent thinking. Never waste a potential resource.
Thank you, Overseer. I'm glad you approve.
What's more important is that Darth Barris would approve.
Now, Devotec, the failed warrior, why grant his wish for a trial by combat?
I needed to discover for certain that he was no longer useful.
That holds some merit, but it should have been obvious he was far past any use. Devotec was an utter waste of space. Once something is no longer useful, it should be eradicated. Remember that. Now, the last prisoner, the Forger. Letting him go was highly questionable. Explain yourself.
Keeping or killing him would be meaningless. Nothing would be gained by either.
Innocent or not, he leaves here with first-hand knowledge of our facilities and procedures. It's potentially compromising to have him floating about the galaxy.
You must always be thinking and considering every angle. Aside from a strong and skilled sword arm, that will be what impresses Darth Barris the most. You're beginning to understand what it means to be Sith. But you're far from being able to impress Darth Barris.
I'll try harder, Overseer. I promise.
If you don't, you're doomed. Remember that.
Because I forced you into the Academy ahead of schedule, Darth Barris will be predisposed to judging you severely. And by severely, I mean fatally.
Now, we must hurry to your next trial. Every moment that passes, we risk discovery before we're ready. In the caverns of Mark Aragnos is the beast he left to guard his legacy. Go there, sit among the flames, and wait for the beast to come for you.
I break beasts' necks in my sleep.
Don't be rash. Defeating this creature will take your best effort. Return to the Valley of the Dark Lords and find the tomb of Mark Aragnos. I'll see you when the beast is slain. Good luck.
Acolyte, may I speak to you for a moment?
Sure, why not, Sentry? Go ahead.
Thank you. I'm honored that you would do me the courtesy. There was another acolyte, not long ago, who entered this tomb and did not come back. He died in there.
Tell me how he died.
I don't know, but I could tell he was dying. I heard him scream, even through the great tomb doors. The acolyte who went in there, He was a good sort. Friendly and talkative. He said he was entering the tomb to prove himself to his father. I just thought it would be nice if somebody took his body back and told his father he didn't make it.
Yes. The father should be told that his son has fallen.
I'd never survive in there. And even if I did, I wouldn't be allowed to see his father. He is a Dark Honor Guard stationed in the Academy. None but Sith can ever set foot on the sacred ground where he stands watch. But you could find the body and bring it to his father. Please, do this and honor the fallen.
I will take care of that.
Thank you so much. If you find the acolyte's remains inside the tomb, let me know. I can tell you where to find his father in the Academy. Good luck.
Have the entrance uncovered by the time I finish killing your new master.
Can't say I'm surprised to see you, Venrin. You're remarkably predictable.
My passions run deeper than yours. I am the true essence of what it is to be Sith. My legacy has suffered long enough. After today, you will be forgotten. It ends here and now.
Such adversity, only to be proven unworthy?
I've waited a long time to put you in your place. Consider this. Killing you was easy.
Then do it! Finish me!
Talk right now.